I had to pray the brick house today because that's exactly what I am. You feel me? Good morning, y'all. Welcome to my segment, Chronicles of a Fly Girl. Woo! Hey, Mantu is me, so she's a brick. I'm a brick house. She's mine to my dad. I'm letting it all hang out. Okay, listen up. Oh, another thing, all y'all brick houses, hey y'all, you know the thick chicks with the small waist, hips, rounded booty, flat tummy. Good morning to all my thick chicks, all my plus size chicks. Hey, to all y'all out here. I ain't trying to leave y'all slim chicks out, you know what I mean? Y'all all pretty, we all beautiful women. All right, we gonna get into Dave's. I was trying to wait for more people to come in, but hey, Dave, Sharon, hey, Lee, hey, look, hey, Ron. All right, listen, I ain't had no little freaking good night last night. I was up a little light, and I'm just tired. My voice is still messed up, but it ain't gonna never be messed up for y'all. So today's topic is, why do we, as women, try to tear each other down? And it's like, that's the topic too, but I got another topic with it. Could paste it on to it. Why do we as women, listen, this ain't me, but you know, hey. Feel it's okay to go after somebody else's significant other. Do you guys that do this, do you lack some type of self-esteem? Or does it feel better when you, I don't know, maybe because you don't have to be committed. Maybe you have something happen to your life when you feel like you know what I mean? You was committed, you can't be committed, so it's better to mess with somebody else's motherfucking man. See, I be like, all y'all motherfuckers, I try to be biased, but this my fucking segment, and I'ma keep it 100. All y'all bitches that fuck with somebody else's man need your ass whipped. Okay, y'all need to be rounded up, tied to a mother, tied to a motherfucking chair, and whipped. I am cracking my ass up, but anyway, I don't understand. See, you know what the problem is that I'm gonna start doing my segments a little later after I take my grandson to school, because I can't really drive and talk to you guys. So it seems like I'm just not listening to you or seeing your comments, but I'm driving. But that is what I'm saying this morning. Why in the fuck do y'all feel the need to mess with somebody, man, or to try to tear another woman down? Is what I'm saying. I ain't perfect and I'm far from it. But I'm gonna tell you one goddamn thing. I have never in my life went after another woman's man. See, they can't cheat if you don't allow it. See, as soon as you know that brother is married, or as soon as you know that brother is taken or been in a committed relationship, you walk your motherfucking ass the other way. That's what the fuck you do. That's what I would do. Because let me tell you something, the oldest trick in the book is for a motherfucker to tell you what his significant other not doing. Oh, you, I come home from work, she ain't cook. Huh. I get in the motherfucking bed and I try to touch her and she don't touch me back. Oh, she let the kids run rampant, the house dirty. These motherfuckers will come up with all types of motherfucking shit. They'll tell you any goddamn thing. You know what I mean? Just to make you feel as though you can do him better. See, first of all, I look at someone's character. Because here's where it all get crazy at. All you gotta do is say to yourself, well, shit, if he can do this to somebody he done made a vow to, or somebody he done been with for years, who the fuck is you, chick? He gonna deck this motherfucker in the back of me. Listen, he's gonna definitely do it to you. You don't think so? Are you serious? Listen, I believe that all motherfuckers that can't be with one woman, especially at an old ass fucking age, got some goddamn issues within themselves. But we as women, we ain't gotta be around to sit up there and be like, oh, okay, well, maybe he cheating on his wife because she ain't do this. Or maybe he cheating on his wife because she, like, you know what I mean, she done gained some weight or whatever. You know they come up with all types of shit. You know what I mean? Because why? Because let me tell you something. When you get settled in a relationship, you're settled. Don't you know how motherfucking good? Oh, these motherfucking goddamn cash only motherfuckers is picked today. Don't you know how it's easy for somebody when they in a relationship, it takes a while to build. The newness is there. You feel me, y'all? Of course you're going when you first went with a motherfucker. It's going to be new. What y'all motherfuckers think? It's new, it's fresh, it's, oh my God, it's exciting. It's all of that. But see, I know how to stay committed. Because see, what you got to do is never forget from the beginning. Good morning. Good morning. Never forget in the beginning how you guys met. Because you always supposed to keep the newness new. Because if you, but first of all, after a while, you can be like, oh, I'm tired of this motherfucker. I know what he doing. He gonna come home. He gonna take his pants off. He gonna fold his pants off. You too. Have a good weekend. You're welcome. He's gonna fold his clothes. He's gonna sit on the side of the bed. Y'all got, excuse me, I'm gonna turn this camera off for a minute. He's gonna sit on the side of the bed and shit. He gonna do this and that. Of course, you know your man after a while. And then it becomes what? The same routine day in, day out. But you can never, in a marriage, in a relationship, ever forget how you guys fell in love, right? You have to keep the newness, okay? Because then, you know what I mean, one get bored, and that's how others start coming in. They start coming in. They start coming in saying, oh, you start saying, oh, this chick, she do this. She ain't wearing nothing sexy no more. See, I tried to keep, see, listen, when I lived in the other, in the Southwest, I used to always try to keep it, you know what I mean? Try to stimulate them and try to keep them, you know, like, you know, to feel. I make them smile. I make them laugh. You know what I mean? Try to make them feel like, you know, we still was dating. Because you don't want to lose that feeling. But I ain't going to take the blame. Because, listen, only blame I have is that when we got to the house, all I did was focus on the house. Isn't that what a good woman do, y'all? I focused on the house. I focused on, you know, trying to make everything feel like a home. Like I said before, I tried to make it feel like a home. I wanted him to feel comfortable. You feel me? I'm trying my best today not to choke this motherfucker out and to keep talking about this fucking motherfucker. But I'm going to tell you one motherfucking thing. Listen, he swears that I go to his shit. He's telling motherfuckers that I go to his. Motherfucker, I don't go to your shit. Motherfuckers call me or text me and tell me, because I heard that yesterday he said that he named all the people that helped him out, right, when he got home from jail. This is how you know this motherfucker is a liar, right? You gotta laugh at niggas. This is what he said. They sent the screenshot and said that he was like, oh, shout out to my little sis. Okay, let's not even get on the little sis, honey, because you were on the bus doing 17 years. You got out in front of her door and that motherfucker wasn't home. And three times a man rode around was going to send your ass back to jail, okay, because she wasn't home. Let's not get on the sister seat. Niggas is something else. So listen, he said nobody helped him out. No, he named the people that helped him out. Okay, here's where y'all going to laugh. Here's where y'all going to know he's a liar. Okay, you've been out 6 years. I've been with you 5. My throat's so sore, right? But motherfucker, if you've been out 6 years and you've been with me 5, who the fuck ain't help you out? You's a fucking goddamn weirdo. But anyway, y'all, we're gonna get back on the stuff. We're gonna get off of him. You know what I mean? We're gonna get off of him. All right, listen. Why do y'all chicks go after somebody else's motherfucking man? That's the day's topic. Don't y'all motherfucking hoes want your own damn man? Get your own shit. Why you riding mine? That's how I feel. In the words of motherfucking Little Kim, that's my bitch. I'm going right to her show. Anyway, yeah. Like, anyway, that's like anything. Yo, that's my man. So get your own shit, bitch. Stop riding mine. But listen, if we as women don't get a man an opportunity to cheat, right, y'all? Then why? Then he wouldn't be able to cheat. See? You don't gotta fall for. I'm telling all y'all, just in case Johnny Go Lucky come to fuck around and tell y'all his motherfucking chick ain't doing this, or she ain't fucking him right, she ain't doing this and she ain't doing that. Let me tell you one motherfucking thing, y'all, and to anybody that know, cause see, I'm an old head, so I'm seasoned. Y'all already know. Let me tell you something. You can fuck a nigga all day. You can cook a nigga favorite motherfucking meal. You can dress up in the freakiest shit. You can role play. You can keep the motherfucking house spotless. The nigga can lick the motherfucking floor so goddamn clean. But let me tell you motherfuckers one thing. To a motherfucker that's ungrateful, okay, and to a motherfucker that's just not worthy, that motherfucker gonna cheat anyway. Because let me tell you something. A motherfucker that's not worthy, or a motherfucker that's ungrateful, they don't give a fuck what you do. Stop it, y'all. Stop fucking. And another thing, stop catering to these men, okay, that don't need to be catered to. It's specific. Let me tell y'all a little story about when I was younger. See, I always got a story to tell because I'm an old head and I done been through some motherfucking shit. And that's one thing about me. I ain't never feel like I'm too old to learn. I always keep my motherfucking mind, okay? I always keep my mind open. Because let me tell y'all another thing. No one is going to teach a mother, Mr. Fucking or Mrs. Know-it-all nothing. So that is why sometimes you need to shut the fuck up and learn something. Because everyone that comes through your life and through your life will teach you something if you open up your fucking mind. You hear me? Hey, girl. Why, dear, if you open up your motherfucking mind and you listen, you'll learn something. All right, let's go back to when I was a little girl. I'ma say, around 10 years old. And how this stick to me? This stuck to me my whole life. Me and my cousin used to see my uncle. My uncle would come home, and I would spend the night over there sometimes. My aunt would run around. I ain't gonna say she ran around like Ida, but listen what she would do. She would run around, child. My uncle came home. He had his bath water. He had his slippers out. He had his motherfucking clothes washed, dinner ready. I mean, shit, even had the motherfucking newspaper open if he ain't read it that day. So what me and my cousin would do was, I still got a cold. We were looking at my aunt like she was a nut. I mean, back then you ain't say nut or whatever. We was just laughing. We would giggle like little girls. So I guess she caught us one day because this went on for a long time. She said, come here. So I remember and I looked her right in her face. She said, let me tell y'all something. And you remember this for the rest of your life. You cannot cater to anyone. You cater to the man that caters to you. Now let me tell you how my uncle catered to her. My freaking aunt never had a job. My aunt, this is my aunt Marjorie, in case they think I'm talking about my other aunt. This is my other aunt. So she said, listen, that man, I don't work. That man feeds me. That man clothes me. This man pays my bills. This man is my peace in a world full of fucking chaos. And I cater to him because he does the same for me. See, this is where we as women fuck up it. You know why we fuck up? Because we cater to the motherfuckers that don't supposed to be catered to. Why in the fuck are y'all chicks catering to a motherfucker that cheat on you? Why are y'all chicks catering to a motherfucker that call you out your name? Why are y'all chicks catering to a motherfucker that put his hands on you? Why do y'all chicks cater to a motherfucker that sit on y'all motherfucking couch all day, play motherfucking PlayStation, and eat your kids' snacks? Come on now. Y'all up here, I see y'all all the time. I'm listening, especially when I know your motherfucking story. I sit up here and see you all the time. Oh, happy birthday to my hubby. Oh, happy birthday to my baby. Oh, I'm taking him out because he deserves. Bitch, please. That motherfucker cheating on your motherfucking ass, been cheating on your ass for a long motherfucking time. Why the fuck? Don't get that motherfucker nothing. See, I'm going to tell you one thing. Like, when I go back and I tell y'all that I'm a boss now, I done been through some shit. Yes, I've been with cheaters. Yes, I've been with motherfuckers that had put their hands on me and called me out my name. But I listen to what I'm going to tell you what I didn't do, though. I ain't catered to the motherfucker. I treated that motherfucker like shit. Do you hear me? I'm going to tell y'all something so fucking funny. My kid's father used to, my son's father used to smoke Lucy's. And when he would smoke Lucy's, you know what he would do? He would go around the fucking house and find change. Bum, right? So guess what I would do? Every motherfucking day, I make sure if I got to get my fat ass on my knees, I made sure I ain't leave no motherfucking change around the crib for him. That nigga be, when I get home from work, you ain't working, nigga? That nigga be around that motherfucker sweating. He had a cigarette all day. Now, I'ma tell you something. I can be a motherfucking mean person. But like I try to tell y'all, yeah, I'ma talk heavy because these motherfuckers need to hear it. Like I try to tell y'all, listen. I ain't never catered to no motherfucking man that didn't deserve to be catered to. Now, when I was a young girl, when I had my kid's father, my daughter's father, he was all around the neighborhood cheating and shit. I was too young to figure out how to cater to him. All I gave a fuck about was that motherfucker running that cash home. You know what I mean? Keeping a motherfucking chick fly because, listen, I had to learn when I was younger that don't mean nothing. I would never accept a nigga that gave me the world but disrespected me. You know what I mean? Like cheated on me, did all this shit. I would never accept anything. I don't want your fucking money. I don't want your fucking gifts. Because at the end of the day, I want someone when I'm not around, right? That's going to defend my ass. I want somebody to say, oh no, chick, bitch, please. Even if he got to say, bitch, please. Huh, I ain't fucking around on mine. You got me fucked up. This my shit, I ain't fucking this up. That's the type of nigga I want. See, but when I was a young girl, I thought being fly was on the outside. You know what I mean? Oh, he keeps me laced the fuck up. I'm gonna keep 100. Everybody, listen, we all gotta be young and pray to God that we all get older. So listen, I used to be like, shit, that motherfucker keep me motherfucking laced. I don't give a fuck. He can cheat, he can do whatever. You know what I mean? I used to always argue with the bitches that used to mess with him because they always, I don't know why the hoes feel the need to always call me and fuck with me, bitch. All right, listen. So I would tell them, bitch, I don't give a fuck because I done left that motherfucker. That motherfucker ain't got shit left. He got, you can get a bag of weed, though. That's all I left because I'm motherfucking, I shops in different states. So you can motherfucking have that bag. You might got a bag of weed. Maybe y'all can get a few blunts out there. But I ain't leaving shit. But that was my young girl mentality. See, when you young, you think so fucking dumb. Listen, but it ain't take me a long time to get it because I was always wise above my years because I always hung with older women. I always hung with older people. And I listen. That's the key in life. Listen. Listen. When you open up your mind and listen, you'll learn something. So why I call this segment Chronicles of a Fly Girl is because when I was a young girl, like I just said, I thought that being fly meant, bitch, I got all the bags, bitch, I got all the shoes, bitch, I got all the jewelry. Nah, motherfucker, that ain't what fly means. You know what fly girl mean? Fly girl mean that I ain't never gonna set a motherfucking cheater. Fly girl mean that I ain't never gonna accept a motherfucker put their hands on me. Fly girl mean I ain't never gonna accept a motherfucker that call me out my name, okay? Fly girl mean I ain't gonna never accept a motherfucker that don't get his own income, that don't get at a dollar. Y'all got me fucked up. One thing about me, honey, I ain't taking care of no nigga. Now, I might have brought the nigga up as far as him being with me, staying with me and all that shit, but I ain't gonna physically sit around and just give you all my paper, nigga. I like nice shit. So what the fuck? I'm not gonna sit around and do that. You feel me? But anyway, why do y'all chicks? Stop it, girls. Stop it. When that motherfucker got a motherfucking wife, or when he got a fucking a girlfriend, or he's been in a committee with someone he's with, and don't believe that fucking old trick when he tell you that, oh, I ain't sleeping with her. I sleep in another room, or I don't sleep. Man, please. That motherfucker roll right over every motherfucking night, and he doing it to her. Trust me when I tell you, because that motherfucker told motherfuckers, I ain't fuck him in a year. You know what? But you know what? Listen, let's just go on. People that are liars are very fucking, something wrong with them. Something even, I don't know. Why the fuck do people feel the need to lie, number one? See, I ain't going to lie because, let me tell you something, lying, I got to keep remembering the motherfucking lie. Like, you know what I mean? Like, why do I want to keep remembering the lie? I'm going to come back on here so y'all can see me. Because, you know, I had to put my glasses on today because My motherfucking ass ain't getting no damn sleep, so I was tired. But I'm gonna tell you one thing that a motherfucking nigga can't do to me. He can't come to Big Lean and tell Big Lean his bitch ain't doing this, or tell Big Lean she ain't, she ain't cleaned the house, she ain't fucked me, oh, that bitch ain't got no communicate. I don't, motherfucker, you better turn your, listen, motherfucker, didn't you sign up for this? Because I tell you, boy, before motherfuckers get married or before they stay in a relationship this long, they already know how the person is. See, the problem with today's society and this internet and all this social media shit going on, people don't know how to communicate. You know what I mean? When I talk to niggas, I don't even really want to text your ass. Why would I want to? I'm not texting nobody. I'm picking up the mother. If I can't pick up the phone to talk to you, because listen, the one thing about this society is that these motherfucking young kids, they don't know how to communicate. You know what I mean? You could be anybody you want to motherfucking be. Back in the day, we had to use the mother. Listen, we outside, we got to use the pay phone. We got to use the home phone. Niggas had to come, catch buses, whatever, how they did to come see you. This internet shit, everybody pretending to be something they fucking not. Stop pretending to be something that you're fucking not, because that's fucked up. Listen, let me tell you something. Every day I get up with motherfucking me. Why would I lie to me? Why would I not fucking be true to me? Man, this bitch right here go with me everywhere I go. And I am never going to fucking deceive her. That's me. I love my fucking self. Let me tell you something. When you allow a fucking man that's in a relationship or married to play you, let me tell you one motherfucking thing. You is not being true to yourself. You gotta, sometimes I feel so sorry when older niggas get young girls. That's another thing bothers my fucking, and ooh, because let me tell y'all something. When a baby girl is young, she don't know a lot. You know what I mean? She don't know how, you know what I mean? Niggas going, how they act and how they pretend and how they play. They go and get these girls so they can manipulate them. I can't stand a nigga like that. Listen, every time my daughter's friends get older, man, I get a fucking attitude. Yeah, I do. Because I know you're trying to ruin that young girl. You better fucking leave her the fuck alone. That's how I, listen, I got to keep my pistol strapped because I always got to run my fucking mouth. I ain't fucking scared of nothing. Hey, Kim. Hey, Boo Boo. Hey, Tamika. Hey, T, John, what's going on, y'all? Hey, Niecy Pooh. Hey, mwah, mwah. I love you guys. I love all y'all. Y'all so good. I'm so happy y'all turned into my segment because I got shit to say that people don't want to say. Now, let me tell y'all something again. Why do we as women mess with other people, men? That was my segment of the day because I was going to use it Tuesday, but I don't know. I get sidetracked. You know, but listen, I want to be a motivational speaker. I'm going to be. One day, I'm going to walk across somebody's stage and I'm going to make motherfuckers feel fucking happy. I'm going to let chicks know how to make moves in this motherfucking world. One day I am. So every day when I get up before I turn this on, this might just be petty Facebook I'm starting with now, but listen, I got bigger goals, okay? So I always got a motherfucking goal because I'm a hustler. But anyway, I asked God, I said, God, give me something. Please speak on me, God. Let me see what I can say to somebody this morning where I can help somebody out. See, because let me tell you something. I don't give a fuck about nothing. Only thing I ever cared about, one thing about me, I help people out. That's why I'm blessed. That's why I'm blessed. I don't worry about nothing. Somebody call me, ask me for 20 hours, whatever. If I got it, I'm going to give it to you because God going to give it back to me a million freaking times. I don't worry about that. So today I asked God, like I do every morning when I started this, is to give me something to talk about. So this weighed on my heart. Why do we as women mess with other people, man? Now, I ain't trying to make it seem like y'all bad people, but I'm going to let you know is that, listen, babies, when you mess with somebody else's fucking man, let me tell you, we as women are emotional creatures. That karma comes back because let me tell you about something. No matter how hard we think we is, once we allow a motherfucker to enter our body, they stay with us for a long time. Why you think I ain't over old fat boy yet? Because I let him enter my body and he's inside of me. See, I got to focus. I got to pray. I got to do a lot of things to get him out of here. See, y'all don't know. That's why I don't have sex. Why I remain celibate. He been gone 4 months. And I ain't had sex and I won't because I need time. Because the next nigga I let up in here, he gonna be right because I ain't doing this again, okay? But anyway, once you let somebody enter you, don't you know that they're stuck in there? They're there. So we emotional creatures, right? Let's get back on being emotional. No matter how tough we say we are, oh, I don't need a man. Fuck a man. I ain't loving nobody, bitch, please. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. So when you mess with somebody else, nigga, right? One day, one sweet old day, someone gonna come along, right? You're going to fall head over heels. You're going to love that money. You're going to love the shit out his drawers. You know what I mean? You're going to love him. I'm always turning my fucking windshield wipers on. You're going to love the shit out that man. But guess what's going to happen? Huh? Guess what? Karma. That bitch going to be putting her makeup on, getting her ass dialed up. You know what I mean? Warming her car up, sitting there looking beautiful. Guess what she gonna do? Come ring your motherfucking doorbell. Don't tell me. I ain't perfect. But I'm gonna tell you one thing. When you fuck with somebody else's man, fuck what that nigga say. He gonna come to you and be like, oh, she ain't doing this. Oh, motherfucker, please. I don't care. I don't give a fuck what the bitch do. Matter of fact, don't talk to me about your bitch. That's your problem. Once I find out you taking, it's a wrap. I'm poop. Two fingers up, nigga. Two fingers up. I had to put these shades on y'all because, listen, no, I ain't getting no rest last night. I was up a little bit. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I ain't. Yeah, you know I mean, I ain't gonna say. I ain't still a little bit hurt, but I ain't sleep well last night. But it's okay because tonight I'm gonna pray. Just like I pray every night, but I'm gonna pray and ask God to send that motherfucker Mr. Sandman my way so I can get some sleep and get old fat ass off my mind. But anyway, that's what I'm trying to tell y'all. Y'all gonna have to stop this because let me tell you, if we don't allow that man to cheat on his significant other, we say no, ain't gonna be no cheating going on, right? How long can a man hide the fact that he got somebody? Okay? So if we don't allow him to do it, he ain't gonna be able to do it, right? That's what I'm saying. So that's what I'm saying is, I don't know if you may, maybe, I don't know if you think that you mess with somebody else, nigga. You know what I mean? Maybe it's something inside of you. That's fucked up. Troy, welcome to my segment, Chronicles of a Fly Girl. That's my baby, Troy. That's my baby, Monica. Oh, all my fucking friend, real friends is here. Gregory, all I'm trying to do, listen, I ain't trying to do nothing for fame and popularity. I'm trying to help y'all. Because at the end of the day, boy, please. At the end of my grandson, I'm going to punch his nose in. At the end of the day, people get to my inbox all day long. I remember Troy was like, stop telling these motherfuckers and get paid for it. But listen, they get in my inbox and what I do, I help you out because I done been through anything. And not only have I just, it's not the fact that I've been through stuff too. I'm a wise motherfucker. I've been wiser than most. You know, this goddamn chain is getting on my nerves. You know what I'm saying? But I try to be cute for y'all today. You know what I mean? Listen, I always been wise, right? And above my years. So today's topic is, why do we as women tear each other down, right? And why do we as women mess with somebody else's significant other? Because listen, I don't go around tearing no chicks down. Like I told y'all before, when this man was in my freaking inbox and he was trying to holler at me, but he had a girlfriend. So I, you know, as soon as somebody get my inbox, I don't answer them all in my inbox because if I did, I wouldn't get no sleep at night. I mean, these motherfuckers in my inbox. Because people like to catch you when you down and out, right? And try to latch on to you. Because they want to be a part of who you are. Bitch. Get your own motherfucking identity. Let me turn. Wait, don't you touch that door. Okay. Don't you. This damn boy. Oh, my God, y'all. I had to turn the freaking thing around because this little boy, honey. Yeah. Oh, gosh. I know grandma get on this side because grandma we can get out this way. Y'all know the routine. Y'all know the routine except today. I got stuff to do. I got stuff to do in Jersey. I don't have nothing to do in Philly. Alright, go ahead, baby. Have a good day. Grandma loves you. Okay, grandma loves you. Have a good day. You're welcome. Bye. Let me make sure he up in here, because you know, babies. I always been funny about my kids. Listen, they snatch kids, honey. I make sure that yeah, and I used to get my kids a passcode. But anyway, yeah, why do we as women do this? Let me see what Troy said, because he gets on my damn nerves. There's a shorter man, so these women need men taken or not. There's a shorter man, okay. There's a shorter man, right? Well, that so you trying to say that the man, since there's a shorter man, that the men supposed to just go on and spread their little oats around, right? And mess with whoever. I don't give a fuck how many goddamn men. Once I snatch mine, he mine. I don't give a fuck if y'all bitches is out here with no man. Which is y'all crazy? Come on now. Is you crazy, Troy? Stop it, Troy. Troy, you ain't gonna fuck with me today because you're raising motherfucking pressure. And I mean, you know, I gotta learn to be open to your ass because, oh, you gonna get me. You gonna make me wanna find you. You know, I know where your ass at. We've been best friends for fucking many a years. I love me some Troy. But I love Troy because Troy will speak his mind. He really is a damn Virgo. But anyway, I don't give a fuck if it is a shortage of men, Troy. Who cares? Once that nigga is my man, I ain't worrying about that shit. Dad, well, what are you supposed to be? Oh, I'm so old, man. I gotta go around and take care of all these chicks. Being as though it ain't a lot of us men out here. Yeah, come the fuck on with that bullshit. Stop that bullshit. Come on now. Boy, you funny. But anyway, if the men is out here cheating, right? Why the fuck you gotta throw your goddamn significant other in it? Oh, she ain't doing this. She ain't, motherfucker, just cheat. Okay, why you gotta throw somebody under the goddamn bus? Cause listen, when that motherfucking old ugly ass motherfucking dyke called little boy, called me, she was like, yeah, that's why I'm fucking him. Yeah, that's why, she said, yeah, you don't fuck him. All you think is doing crafts and cooking. Let me tell you something, bitch. You ain't gonna make me feel bad that God gave me a gift and I can craft, bitch, because guess what? If crafting wasn't a gift, all these motherfuckers would know how to craft. You think you, listen, nobody can ever make my motherfucking self-esteem go down. So that's what I'm trying to say. You gonna call and try to tear me down. You got me fucked up. You can't tear me down, bitch. Because I've been built myself up. Girl, so me, bitch, before you was born. Okay? So you can never tear me the fuck down. But I'm saying I've never in my life went about trying to tear another woman down. That's just not who I am. I mean, maybe they don't make them like me no more. Maybe. I don't know what's going on. I really don't. Only thing I know is that my character will never sit around and down another woman. I just can't do that. I'm sorry. There's no way in the damn world I will ever do that. Because let me tell y'all something about when a woman's heart is broke and her man. Don't get Troy started, Wanda. Yeah, he gonna get my... Yeah, he gonna get... Girl, Wanda, get your... Girl, yeah, your pressure up. I'll be in the motherfucking house on a motherfucking goddamn fucking heart monitor fucking with Troy. Shit. You know how Troy is, but I love Troy. Troy is... He's a very opinionated motherfucker. But some of his shit will make you want to kill him. You know, because you know he do be talking that shit. He do be right. There really is a shortage of men. Because a lot of our men are either dead or incarcerated. You know what I mean? They're either there. You know what I mean? So, I got mine from the depths of the prison. I got mine from jail. So, y'all wasn't missing shit when he got out here. But I gotta laugh because I was just saying that he said, someone told me that he said, they sent a screenshot, I don't mind it, because I laugh, so you know what I mean? He says that nobody helped him. He named the people that helped him since he been home, okay? But here's where it get funny, or gay, right, Kim? Undercover, that's not even, we gonna do that another day. But we gonna do that another day, Kim, that's a good topic, girl. Keep reminding me, you know how we talks. But anyway, Oh, excuse me, y'all. I got a terrible, terrible allergy cold. And I feel like this is so nasty for me to do. But I would not miss my segment for nothing in the world. It's Monday through Friday, 7:45 every day. I don't know when it's going to end. It stops when I fucking feel like it. But anyway, my man was from jail, so he told everybody that he ain't had, you know, nobody helped him. He named the people. But mighty funny how you've been out 6 years and I've been with you five. Do the math. You do the math. See, I was cracking up when he had this self-esteem. He would just hold his little shoulders together because he was so petrified of the world. And I held his hand. You know what I mean? Now there's this laid-back, arrogant motherfucker. But that's all me. See, but that's all me. So whoever the bitch getting, that's all me. You know, and then it's crazy how you think that you're going to go with me, be with me for 5 years, build a life, but you think you're going to go somewhere else and build a life and build a credit and all this shit. You got me fucked up. You got me fucked up. I'm always on. Listen, I ain't going to let that little boy get two motherfucking steps ahead of me. I'm a fucking wife, and I'm going to act like a wife. I remember how, let me tell you something. The reason why I don't be nobody motherfucking girlfriend is because a wife means a lot. Trust me when I tell you. I don't give a fuck. You can run around with that nigga all the fuck you want to. Listen, I knew that when my motherfucking, do dirty, had got, when it was in the hospital, I ain't going to tell his business. When he was in the hospital, right, and a little bitch that he was used to creep around with was coming up there. I mosey my fat ass down that motherfucker and told them motherfuckers, gave her the name, and gave them her name and said, listen, don't let this motherfucking bitch back up here. They said, who are you? I'm the motherfucking wife. Guess what? The little bitch was so mad she come to motherfucking University of Penn. Bitch ain't never drove. Y'all know a motherfucker probably had to get on the L and a goddamn fucking trolley. Bitch got to the motherfucking front desk. They let that bitch know you can't come see him. Why? The bitch called me, cussing me out. I said, hold up. She said, who the fuck is you? Bitch, who the fuck you think I am? Bitch, I'm the wife. You can't come up there, bitch, because I said so. You hear me? That's how I'm with this motherfucking bitch. Bitch, you ain't building no fucking credit for him. Bitch, you ain't getting no fucking other apartment or house. You ain't getting another motherfucking car, bitch. You ain't getting shit but a meal, dick, weed, and liquor. Why, bitch? Because I said so. Because I'm the motherfucking wife. Because I'm the motherfucking wife. That's why I don't never stay past a girlfriend past 2 years. Y'all got me fucked up. Y'all got me fucked up. Never will I do. Because guess what? This title I hold means something. You know what I mean? See, these motherfuckers, this nigga, he thinking through the Islam way. All right? You think because you married me through Islam, you done told somebody, probably went to the email, done said 3 times you ain't married. Yesterday, I just was in a mood. I had heated up me some tea, right? Sat my ass down, threw me a little bit of honey in there, went to my motherfucking safe. Guess what I did? Pulled out my marriage license, looked over it, said, I swear to God, Lean, when they say you ain't a boss, they a motherfucking lie. Because guess what? Oh, what you gonna do when Big Lean come for you? Okay? I ain't stupid. That's one thing, I ain't never been stupid. Because let me tell you something. If I was stupid, I won't be sitting up in where the fuck I'm sitting at. Okay? Because see, you can't build a motherfucker, bitch, that I already built it. Because you want to run around and mess with somebody else fucking man because you got a low self-esteem. Here she go. Been a bum her whole life. See, this is another thing. I don't know if I should take this topic today or should I save it for another day. Listen, I'll never run out of topics because I'm motherfucking ass always running my motherfucking mouth. But here I go with this motherfucking fucking topic. This bitch think that she ain't had shit her whole life. Bum ass clown, and now all of a sudden you get somebody else's husband, you're gonna build yourself up. You're gonna get your broke ass out that fucking apartment. You're gonna get your ass a fucking car. You're gonna get your ass some credit. You're gonna get your ass a savings account. Oh no, bitch, you won't. I promise you. You won't, bitch. Because here we go again. When I said, stop messing with somebody motherfucking else's fucking man. Y'all motherfucking wives, y'all know y'all niggas is cheating. Y'all leave them niggas alone. But before y'all leave them alone, you show them why you got a fucking marriage license. Stop being sweet as putting fucking pie and get with these motherfuckers and let them know why you, okay, girl, is the shit. Because come when I'm ready, you best believe you me, I ain't said a damn thing to the nigga. I don't never want to see the nigga again, but I got something for that nigga. You think I'm stupid? You got me fucked up. You got me fucked up. And I can say I got something for the nigga, but I ain't got to tell you what I got for the nigga. Let that nigga wonder, because ain't a motherfucker in his camp. He know smarter than me. Not that little bitch that's pretending to have something. Oh, get your credit right. Bitch, you ain't smarter than me. Bitch, I'm devious. And when I'm done with that nigga going to be sitting on a motherfucking corner talking to his fucking self. Because I'm going to tell you one thing. Don't fuck with me. Don't fuck with me. You know what I mean? Listen, you marry my motherfucking ass. I thought we was going to be married forever. But since you want to play games, pussy, I'm going to show you how to do it. But I'm going to tell y'all motherfuckers, stop fucking with these niggas that belong to somebody else. Because at the end of the day, you got to remember, if he do it to you, them, he going to do it to you. You got to look at somebody's character. If that man is around here, running around, cheating on his motherfucking wife, who the fuck is you? You think, or his girlfriend, fiance, whatever. Who the fuck you think you are? You don't think you're exempt. You think your pussy blows somebody motherfucking mind that much that he ain't gonna do it to you? Bitch, please. Pussy all pussy. Pussy is pussy. Okay? It ain't about the pussy and how deep and good the pussy is. It's about who's attached to the pussy. Trust me when I tell you. So stop trying to make it seem like your pussy is motherfucking drop dead gold. You think somebody gonna leave? Only, listen, first of all, niggas ain't stupid. They don't even leave their wives. You know what I mean? But you gonna get a big ass motherfucking clown that did 17 years in jail. He don't know. You done manipulating that damn fucking slow ass man. Because I know damn well I could have. No, I did not manipulate him to get this damn fucking house, okay? No, I did not. I'm not a manipulator, okay? I just put my motherfucking name on. I got 5 on it. Let me stop. But anyway, no, I'm not a manipulator. That's what he wanted to do because he wanted to live a better life. I guess that when he got out there, nigga, he wasn't capable of it. He wanted to be in a gutter. You feel me? But what I'm saying is stop fucking somebody else's goddamn fucking man, girl, and get your own goddamn shit. And just like Lil' Kim say, get your own shit while you're riding mine. You know what I mean? You can ride the dick, though, girl, because, listen, I don't want that fucking... Listen, that's one thing about me. Once you done stepped out, honey, I ain't fucking with you no motherfucking more because I got shit to do. I got paper to get. I got to eat. See, you got to remember, motherfucker done left me. But he's so dumb. Listen, I can say, I know this motherfucker ain't this motherfucking dumb.
I know he ain't goddamn, I knew you was slow, but I ain't know you was this motherfucking slow. But now that I know you real slow, I ain't got no motherfucking love for you. I'ma do you just like I said. You know what? I'm a wife and I hold a title. Y'all motherfuckers better stop being these girlfriends for all these 20 years, niggas talking about something. Oh, I ain't got enough money. You know what I mean? We ain't buy that house. We ain't do that. Nigga, go down to motherfucking City Hall, motherfucker. I don't give a fuck. If we was living in this motherfucker for 20 motherfucking years, nigga, you ain't getting nothing. What the fuck? 20 more years later, you still ass ain't gonna get nothing. Stop motherfucking letting these niggas manipulate y'all and y'all keep staying somebody's fucking girlfriend. I ain't nobody motherfucking girlfriend. I ain't gonna be your girlfriend past 2 years. I don't give a fuck how many goddamn marriages I got under my belt. I am a motherfucking wife. And I know that this, listen, it taught me young. I was a young wife, remember? I was somebody's wife. Before I was even what? I was like 25. Before then, I was a wife. So I knew. Oh, listen, I learned at a young age how to manipulate that motherfucker. How to do that wife title. I did that wife title so good. I told you that girl used to be mad at me. She used to call my motherfucking ass with dumb shit. And I used to be like, what's wrong with you? I'm sorry. Only things left is a bag of weed. You high? You high? Because that's all that's left, bitch. Because I got everything. Stop calling me. You know what I mean? Not them Reebok broads. He made it known who the wife was. See, wives make moves. Well, real wives, because I'm a wife. I make a move. I'm a boss, honey. I got something for brother man. That's why I cracks up. He be smirking. Like, they got that motherfucking big cheek smiling. That motherfucking arrogant ass smirk. I remember when that nigga couldn't even open his mouth. He was sitting around so fucking petrified of the world. Now you this motherfucking gangster. You know what I mean? Every fucking thing you do, nigga, I taught you how to do. You can get on here and tell the world whatever you want. I know, and you know. You feel me? And then you gonna go to my shit, try to boost your fucking self up. Stop it. Stop trying to get numbers up, nigga, over me. I got street cred. I'm a wife, and I'm a boss. But my thing is listen, why do y'all women keep messing with other people, man? Stop messing with other people, fuck man. Stop it. Get your own shit. Toy says it's a shortage of men out here. No, it ain't. If it is, you go find one that ain't nobody attached to. It's something I'm out here. If that was the case, it wouldn't be all these marriages. It wouldn't be all these relationships. You feel me? So come on now. Oh, motherfucking man. I do this dumb shit all the goddamn fucking time. Anyway, if that was the case, it wouldn't be a damn fucking shortage. Y'all feel me? So it's a shortage because... That's what, I don't know. They said, when I was reading, one time I got, and I was reading, they did say it was a shortage of men because most of our black men is either incarcerated or they're fucking dead because y'all motherfuckers keep killing each other. Y'all keep killing each other, killing a good dick. Just letting a good dick just die. Stop it. And then there's people that's in jail. Y'all need to stop doing these nut-ass motherfucking crimes, okay? And y'all got to sit there and beat y'all dick for the rest of y'all life when y'all could have been out with a good woman. You know what I mean? Because every fucking man need a good woman beside him to make him fucking better. I don't give a damn what nobody say. Every man needs that in his life. You know what? Let me get my ass over here. Yes, you do. Because we women make your ass fucking better. So I don't know if it's some kind of like low self-esteem when you go find somebody else's man. I'm telling y'all this because I want y'all females to know. Stop it, okay? Stop falling for the games when he tell you that the wife ain't or the girlfriend not doing this. Stop it, okay? Because you got to remember that he's only manipulating you to get some new pussy because he want to feel something new. Not just the pussy. He want to feel a new relationship. Like I told y'all, sometimes we get so comfortable in a relationship that we forget about why we fell in love. That's why it's very important. Important in your relationship to make your relationship feel as if it's still new, because then you guys won't sit around here and be trying to look for significant others. Other people. Like I said, I slacked a little bit. I did, because I was so into the damn house. You know, I kept saying, listen, we did a lot of things. We went away. We did a lot of things. I did a lot for that man. You know what I mean? So I'm saying, like, listen, I was like, Jay-Z, I was just getting with this house, but I'm going to get right back. You feel me? But he ain't wait. But anyway, so when you with someone, always make that person feel special. You know what I mean? Because there's always that clean up woman on the side coming to steal your man. But like I said, my man this time going to be so fucking powerful because he going to have already done this. See, I'm seasoned. I'm old head. I'm going to get me somebody that I'm fuck all the baddest bitches in the motherfucking world. Somebody that got all the motherfucking play, hustle, had all the cash in the world. I'm going to get with somebody that lived in the nicest shit so that I can know that that nigga is used to shit. Because once you with somebody that's not used to nothing, ladies, listen, let me get back on here. Once y'all get used to somebody, once y'all get somebody that's not used to nothing, right? That's how they act, though. A motherfucker that ain't used to nothing, they gonna act, they gonna wild out. But if I'ma get my man, he gonna have done all this shit in the world. He done had the baddest chicks, so when a bitch, he gonna know that when a bitch come to him, he know the game. Bitch, I don't give a fuck, you badder than my chick. Matter of fact, you ain't badder than my chick. You know what I mean? Like, listen, he gonna know because he gonna know. So y'all need to stop letting these men manipulate y'all, telling y'all shit about why they gonna cheat on their significant other and why you should help them cheat. Because that's all you're doing is help them. Like, stop it. Because, listen, I told y'all we emotional creatures. So at the end of the day, when y'all motherfuckers go around, you know what I mean? Y'all gonna fall in love. And like I told y'all, Karma gonna be putting that lipstick on, sitting in her motherfucking car, okay? Adjusting her fucking weave. Wig, whatever, and gonna ring your doorbell. Because as soon as you find somebody that you love, it's gonna all happen to you. So that is why I don't do certain shit. Now, I ain't perfect, but I tell you one thing, karma ain't knocking on my door for that. That's why I know that. I don't know why this motherfuckers keep taking my nigga, but I'm gonna tell you one thing. This next one, though, I bet you that motherfucker, because I did right by this one. I catered, I did all the things. I thought he was a good man, so I treated him as such. I treated him like a good man. You know what I'm saying? So listen. She ain't coming knocking on my motherfucking door. So y'all better stop it. Because if we don't go and let these people cheat, then they won't have nobody to cheat with. Stop it. When they say they got somebody, y'all leave them alone. Because listen, everybody got flaws. If they tell you my wife ain't fuck with you, or she ain't clean, she ain't doing this. Bitch, soon as you get with that motherfucker 2 years from now, you ain't clean something, he gonna be telling the next bitch the same thing. Y'all already know I ain't lying. Now, y'all know I'm driving on my segment, but when I get home, when I get relaxed, I always come back. We'll talk about it. We're going to talk about this subject. The subject is, why do y'all women feel the need to bring another woman down when you call a motherfucker and tell them you cheated and then you gloat in their fucking face? That's fucked up. You're a fucked up ass fucking boy. I mean, you're a fucked up ass fucking side chick. Okay? And then these motherfuckers, why do you feel the need, girls, to go around and mess with somebody else's man? Get your own shit. I'm telling y'all, listen, life is better with your own shit. Listen. And you keep that nigga happy, you do what you supposed to do. Because the next one I'm going to get, ooh, girl, he going to be the fucking shit. But anyway, y'all, I'm going to end this little segment because my throat hurt or whatever. Y'all already know the topic or whatever. I'll see you guys on Monday, okay? On Monday, because I'm going to get my ass back over this bridge. I got shit to do. You know I got shit to do, y'all. I got to get money. I got to feed my motherfucking kids. I got to make sure my kids got financial freedom. I got to do a lot of shit. It's a lot on my head since I was left to die. You feel me? Since I was left to die. But like I said, that side bitch won't get my motherfucking money. My motherfucking shit. I'm 25 steps ahead of that bitch. But anyway, have a great weekend. Mwah. Thank you for tuning into Chronicles of a Fly Girl, a Fly Chick. Have a great weekend, guys. I love y'all.